Speaking of the transportation system, Marcos says enhancing the sector is a top priority of his administration for economic growth. He made that remark during the signing of the contract for the electromechanical systems and track works for the North-South Commuter Railway project. Marcos hailed the project as a landmark initiative that will make the Philippines more connected than ever, marking a new era of prosperity.
I assure the Filipino people that the government will strive to modernize and improve the country's transportation system. This will be one of the cornerstones of our progress as we move full speed ahead into a brighter tomorrow.
At least one city in Metro Manila has announced class suspensions ahead of the transport strike. The Marikina City Government declared a week-long cancellation of face-to-face classes across all levels in both public and private schools. The University of the Philippines Diliman also announced they will be shifting to remote teaching and learning modes for the duration of the strike. The Philippine Information and Communications Technology Department launches a free Wi-Fi program at the University of Antique. Jackie Pascual joins us on the line with the details. Jackie?
Hi, good afternoon, good news. The Information and Communication Technology Department has launched the Broadband Lang Masta free Wi-Fi program in Antique Province. This is a rebrand of the National Broadband Plan. For today, free Wi-Fi areas were activated in 150 barangays or villages, including the five campuses of the University of Antique, including in the main campus in Sibalom Town and a campus in an island. DICT Secretary Ivan John Uy and Senator Loren Legarda led the launching ceremony. Secretary Uy said these Wi-Fi spots are free and speed is dependent on the area and the population. He reminds the public to use the free Wi-Fi properly, and they may soon include restrictions like how many gigabytes per day, and some sites will also be blocked. Secretary Uy also mentioned that Starlink will officially be launched in the Philippines in the coming weeks, adding that the Philippines is the only country in Asia to have full Starlink coverage. Uy said it may be expensive for an individual to buy the Starlink device, so he is urging schools or barangays to acquire it, especially in remote areas. For now, Denise, many more free Wi-Fi spots are expected to be set up in the coming weeks. And that's the latest from Antique, Pascual, CBS.
Thanks, Jackie.
The town of Polan now under a state of calamity as the oil spill in the province takes a turn for the worse. The oil has reached the shores of the town. The local government said the entire province may soon be placed under a similar declaration. Environment Secretary Maria Yulo Loizaga is in Oriental Mindoro to assess the situation. The Philippine Coast Guard, meanwhile, says it will investigate the oil spill.
Sa isang aksidenteng katulad nito, laging titignan po kung may negligence o meron pong pagpapabaya, at dyan po sigurado magkakaroon ng culpability yung may-ari. Pero that has to be established ng isang investigation at magkaroon po ng due process.
The Coast Guard also says it will deploy more personnel to affected areas to help contain the leak from the motor tanker Princess Empress. It appeals for help of stakeholders in the oil industry.
Lahat po ng mga available na barko na pwedeng tumulong ay nandun na po sa Nawan, Oriental Mindoro. Ayun din po ang mga Marine Environmental Protection ng Philippine Coast Guard. Tayo po ay nagko-coordinate na rin sa mga stakeholders, pati po yung mga major oil players ay kinakausap natin para matulungan tayo dito sa oil spill response.